fingers are actually coming in sideways, which is not completely unusual. It just can lead to more pain if they're going to be pushing in on these teeth. If you were to lean them, it could also lead to issues with crowding. And then the upper wisdom teeth are these guys up here. And really the reasoning of wanting to get these guys out, you can see the curve of the jaw here. There's just no room for these wisdom teeth to come together to be used functionally, especially with these guys coming in sideways. It's going to be a food trap. You're going to be getting food stuck down in these, and then you're not going to be able to brush, which is going to lead to decay, cavities, not only on this tooth, but the tooth beside it. So we want to get these out now. That way they don't lead to problems down the road. With these guys, sort of a similar thing. They're really far back up here. You know, you getting a toothbrush back here up that high and that far back and then getting floss, it's just going to be almost impossible. So, to avoid problems down the road while you're young, we're going to go ahead and get these off. And, you know, with the mane exposed like this, this is going to be pretty minimal procedure. It's not going to be a lot of pain. It's going to be, you know, a little bit sore, but you'll be able to get through it. I just want to make sure you understand why these should come out. Does that make sense? Okay. Okay. So, and you know, right now I don't see any cavities on them, but I know you were saying that you were getting some pain on these lower ones, and you know, with them coming in sideways, that makes sense of why that's happening. So, this will definitely help get rid of that pain, get rid of any potential problems down the with you have braces, make sure that, you know, the work and money and time you spent with those, everything is maintained and stays the same. Okay, cool. So, you know, I spoke with you a little bit about if you'd been under general anesthesia, so that's, you know, getting put to sleep, and you'd said no. So, just to kind of give you a little idea of what that's like, you come in and no eating or drinking 6 hours before your appointment. So most of my patients will come in the night before. They don't stop eating and drinking after dinner. Wake up with the medicines you take. Very, very small amount of water in the morning just to get those down. No smoking 12 hours before the surgery. I know you said you smoke occasionally. So definitely not 12 hours before. You'll have someone with you the entire time, someone to get you to the appointment, stay here during the duration, and then someone to take you home. So, you know, do you have someone that can do that for you? Okay, awesome. Awesome. And then, of course, after the surgery, no driving, you know, really just taking it easy, relaxing the next couple days. Of course, we can give you, you know, work, school excuse, whatever you need. Just really taking it easy. The day of the surgery, you'll just be kind of tired and out of it. So, of course, not working. But you're going to do great. And I'll give you a little slip of paper for when you go home, so you don't forget until the appointment. As far as post-op instructions for the surgery, I'll go over these with your ride the day of surgery. But just to kind of give you an idea of what's going to happen, you'll wake up like no time has passed. You'll wake up with gauze in your mouth, a little bit groggy. We'll give you a bag of gauze to take home, and you'll be changing those out every 30 minutes until you start to notice, you know, not so much blood pooling up. When it starts to clot more, you'll be able to tell. You'll brush like normal. Some bleeding will occur, that's expected. And just make sure you are brushing. We'll give you ibuprofen prescription. You'll be taking that on a schedule every 8 hours. That's going to help with any inflammation or swelling that you might have. We'll also send you home with a prescription Pyrodex rinse. And this is going to make sure everything stays clean. It's an antimicrobial mouth rinse. person, you're going to be taking that only at night when you're relaxed, of course, not taking that driving, not taking that working, really only if you need it. Then, like I said, the teeth are already coming through the gum, so it's just, it's going to be really minimal. You're young, you're going to heal fast, so really, I don't think you'll need it, but I'll write it for you just in case you do need it. If you do have any swelling, it'll peak on day 3 or 4, and it can last 5 to 6 days. That's expected. Of course, for the next 72 hours, the four S's, this is 72 hours after your surgery, no swishing, spitting, drinking through straw, or smoking. So like I said, you need to brush your teeth. When you brush your teeth, brush like normal, lean over the sink, and just let gravity take all your saliva and toothpaste out. As far as using the mouth rinse, the Paradex, and then also warm salt water rinses, you'll start those the day after surgery. Since you can't swish for 3 days, you're just going to put the Paradex and salt water rinses in your mouth and just rock your head side to side, just to get the motion going, help get food out of those sites where there's going to be a hole for a little while. Lean over the sink, let gravity take everything out. The warm salt water rinses, most of my patients will do this 3 times a day, and usually after you eat, and that's just going to also keep all the food and bacteria flushed out of the sites and clean. Paradex twice a day with that is going to also help keep things really clean and heal up faster. Let's see, I'll give you an ice bag, or Denise, my assistant, will give you an ice bag whenever you are leaving, and you'll be doing this 30 minutes on, 30 minutes off. That's going to help a lot with the pain, because you're going to be sore, it's going to be a little uncomfortable for a few days. Like I said, ibuprofen on the schedule will help so much with any swelling. And then as far as your diet goes, just really no crunchy or hard foods for the next week. Ice cream will feel really good the first couple days. Cold stuff feels great. If you do anything warm, you want to have it at room temperature so you don't burn yourself. You will be numb. Once we put you to sleep, I'll give you some shots to help numb your mouth. And that can last up to 8 hours, so just want to be really careful with what you're eating so you don't bite your tongue. Don't burn yourself. So, warm broths, of course, you're going to be drinking lots of fluids. Try to avoid acidic drinks for the next week. Really stick into water if you can. And that's really the gist of it. If, there's an emergency number on our website, if you do need to get a hold of us, please do not hesitate to call. I rotate with the 3 other doctors that work here on calls, so if there is an emergency, one of us will pick up to speak with you. I do this all day. I do this all day long. And, all my patients do great. They recover great. It is a surgery, so these instructions need to be taken seriously. And of course,